Good day. Ira Epstein with your agriculture wrap-up for this Wednesday, the 2nd of October, 2019. Interesting day. As you can see, the stock market, it's rebounding off its lows, which is nice, about 150 off the lows, but still down 440 points in the Dow, down pretty hard still in the S&P. And it was a day where you saw the metal markets get a good bid, but did they hold the vast amount of it? Well, they did, but not convincingly. In the agriculture markets, we're still looking at continued buying by China of more soybeans. Remember, they'll probably buy that 2 million metric tons that they had been talking about prior to them getting into the States for the October 10th trade meeting with the United States. But the market realizes that that may be a one-off purchase. As we're watching what goes on in Washington politics, I don't know how you make a deal in all this. It's very, very difficult. And on the energy markets, well, I know I got a call from CNBC today. He gave me about 5 minutes notice, come down to the floor, want to talk energies with you. We did our talk there. And what I warned is I said, you know, you got to be a little careful here. These markets have gotten down so much that they could at any point snap back on you like that, especially if you find footing in the stock market. Now, if the stock market keeps going down, they're probably to a degree tied to each other. But when we look at what's going on in the soybeans for the week, it's a beautiful week. You're up 30¾ cents. The market on the weekly charts has cleared that 906¾, and it's not giving it back yet. It is Wednesday. There's two more days, but that's really nice action. When we look at what's happened, we're in a stall. So you had this big up leg, as you can see, and the market's now had what we call an inside day. In addition, if you look at the day's range, the market didn't have that big of a range. I think it had roughly a 7 cent range on the day. And as it turns out, it settled in the lower part of it. It could be that the market wants to pull back a little here. The pattern that we have is a lower low and a higher high. So I have what's called an up thrust at work. And the question is, does it clear this high and accelerate, or does it find resistance at that 920 level? One of the things I was trying to point out the other day, is when the market had come down into the support of the 18 and the 100-day average of closes, as it lifted out of there and eventually moved up, that was a pretty big day. You had a 23-cent range. It sliced right through the 200-day moving average like it didn't exist. So as the market pulled back today, sometimes those numbers that you don't pay attention to can act as a bit of support. What had my interest yesterday, and I'll stay with what I teach, the first challenge of an upper Bollinger Band often results in pros coming out of the market, be it to the upside or to the downside. Is it always that way? Nothing is always that way. It's a percentage play, that's all that it is, but a strong one, as you can see, over and over, so it's something that you pay attention to. Now, if this market were to break down, where's support? Well, we can see it pretty clear at 890¾, the combination of the 18 and the 100-day average of closes. In addition, we had what's called a bullish crossover, where the 18-day average got over the 100. So that's a friendly sign on the chart. And in terms of momentum, you are overbought, you've got bias to the upside, you've hit an upside target, and that's where I'd leave it. So do I think farmers did some hedging? I hope they did, but they don't have to. You know, I'm not guiding their account. When we go to the meal market, you can see how the market rallied up yesterday, got to the 100-day in the upper Bollinger Band. Those numbers are narrowing in. Today, you can see how the market's still paying attention to that. Overbought, hit an upside target. The market has a pattern of a lower low and a higher high and has run into a resistance zone. On pullbacks, I'm looking to see what the market can do. Now, if we look at the close today at 305.60, and you look at the upper Bollinger Band at 306.30, you can see the market did close back under it. So that theory that the first time you hit it, I'm going to stick with often. In the soybean oil, well, now you've got a different pattern developing here. This market's gone into a pause pattern. You have a pattern of lower highs and higher lows. So think of it this way. The market's coming in, and where is it narrowing? Right at this 18-day average. And we've hit that number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 out of 7 days. That's pretty darn good. So the market's looking to see what next. I think you give the bulls a ray of hope if you get over 29.31, and you give the bears an idea that this was just a pause if you get under 28.85. market is oversold. So if the market starts to the upside, it might get a bit more juice out of it because it is oversold. Got to wait and see, obviously. In the corn market, the first challenge of the upper Bollinger Band, actually it's three challenges in a row that you've had, and the market's seeing some resistance. However, you have what's called an embedded reading. Now, an embedded reading only occurs after you first get overbought or oversold. In this case, it's overbought. And then both numbers that make up this slow stochastic are going sideways over 80. When they do that for several days in a row, I call it embedded. When it's lost, which would be the red line closing under 80, the idea there is the market's extended its power, ran out of that thrust, and it might want to pull back to what I call the line in the sand, the 18-day average of closes from which I determine bias in the market. Bias is determined very simple. If the market's over the 18-day average, I say it has upside bias. Downside is under it. And it filters a number of different indicators, including the swing line. But right now, the swing line's not in a trend, per se. In the wheat market, again, you met your first challenge of the upper Bollinger Band and the 100-day average together proved too much for the market. It's pulled back to the 18-day average. The momentum is turned down, the bias is up, and there's no trend. So you seem to have run into a resistance point, but you're not trending one way or the other. In the sugar market, I have been looking for a couple of days here talking to you about it, that number one, this was called running the upper Bollinger Band. Market's overbought, would it get to this combination of the upper Bollinger Band and the 100-day average if it keeps hugging that number, the Bollinger Band? And as you can see, the market yesterday got to it, and today, still literally right there, pretty much unchanged from yesterday. The question is, are we going to embed? Now, here you have first day, which is today, both numbers over 80. Yesterday, both over 80, but not the day before. So you're at your most overbought status point before you can either embed or start a correction. I'm going to say what I said yesterday. I'd be surprised if pros didn't take some money off the table there. In the coffee, the market is fighting for direction. If it takes out 99.30, you can end up with a pattern of lower highs, lower lows, putting into play the potential for the lower Bollinger Band. If the market can get back up over today's highs, the 100-day average becomes the resistance point. And for all purposes, the bias is down, the trend is up, momentum is flat. In the cocoa market, you lost the embedded reading yesterday, and today you kept it lost. That means it can't come back right away. Often, I can only use the word often, I can't use the word always because it wouldn't be true. Often, when you've got 2 days of the lost embedded reading and you can't get it back, this leads price. So if the market's going to drop, I wouldn't be surprised to get it back here. Keep in the back of your mind, you had a bullish event take place. If you take a look yesterday, not today, the 18-day got over the 100 and you followed through with it today. When you get a bullish crossover, the theory that I have, at least, is the market should go for the most recent high, which is 25.14. So as much as I'm saying that the momentum's lost and the odds favor, you're going to get back to that 18-day average, for the moment at least, I've got counteracting forces here, and the bias is up, momentum is down, trend is up. How do you play it? Well, I certainly am not looking for the short side, but the question is it worth staying on the long side? In the cotton market, how many days are you hugging this 18-day average? Sort of looks a bit like soybean oil, doesn't it? Just keeps whipping back and forth here. The difference is it's in an uptrend. It's got the higher lows, higher highs. It has flat momentum. As long as you don't take out 60-20, the bulls have control at this point. And the question is, can they drive the market up into that resistance of 62-67 to 63-07? In the cattle market, as long as you keep that embedded reading, and I've already explained what that means, I look for the buyers in this market to show up. If and when the red line closes under 80, I'll have a different opinion of it. But for the time being, the marketplace is it slid right through the 100-day average in green, pulled back, and it's finding support against it right now. And that, again, is one of those events that I pointed out on earlier charts is not uncommon. in the feeder cattle market, be cautious here. If this market's down at all and under today's lows, the way the math is set up, you probably lose the embedded readings. So for the bulls, the key is to not get under today's low as I see it. When the embedded reading is lost, then you put into play the possibility of the first key moving average, which is the 100-day. Is there anything on this chart that's bearish? No. Can you pull back into this zone? Absolutely. If you go up and don't take this out, you still have in play the upper Bollinger Band again. Last in the hog market, you can see the resistance point, which is the 100-day average. It just showed up and it's done its job. You haven't been able to reach to the upper Bollinger Band. Momentum has turned down. You're without trend. You have a lower low, higher high, upside bias, and now you're caught between the 100-day average and the potential of what do you do with the 18-day average of closes. You know, I talk a lot of technicals here, but with our friends from Modern Trader, we put together a guide to technical indicators. And this is both volumes one and two. I used to offer only volume one, then I'd come back with volume two, but we put them together for you. And as you can see, it covers be it moving averages, the oscillators of momentum, market sentiment index. That used to be the hot thing of the marketplace that everybody wanted to know about. I don't even hear it talked about, but it's a good thing to know. Price time relationships, that's the Arun indicator. And you know, we have videos on that. It's very important to understand. And of course, money management, a trading tool. How do you get all this? Well, we've put it into PDF form. Simply go to our website under free offers, click there. You can get all of our offers if you want. Click off the ones that you want. You can always call my staff, but be careful. That's using the phone. People don't do that anymore. And of course, you can click right here if you're watching me on YouTube, and that'll take you right to that free offers page. I'm Ira Epstein. What a wild trading day. I'll see you tomorrow.